And today what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about rider's position, how we're looking for you to sit, how the positioning of your leg, your arm, your body, your back, and how the body, we want the body to work through while you're riding. And what we're going to do then is we're going to show you how your position influences the way of going of the horse. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to create a mirror image of the horse's position and setup to ours. In other words, what we want is we want the horse to round behind the saddle so it can bend and flex behind the saddle and get its hind leg underneath. We want it to be upright through the shoulder and then shape front. So what we want is the same thing from the rider. George, I want you now just bring your upper body back and upright. So you can see here, George has just brought her upper body more upright. So she's basically got her shoulders over her hips, and then all of a sudden her seat starts to come more underneath of her. So then she starts to be a mirror image of the horse, or the horse starts to be a mirror image of her. So what she's done there, she's pushing the horse away, so she's just sort of allowed the shoulder slightly forward. Now she's going to pick him up, and as she picks up, she's going to make herself tall in the saddle. She's going to shorten the rein. She's going to bring the arm back very slightly, which therefore you get the flexion through the elbow, and then through doing that, because she's starting to compress him, she then closes the leg to make sure he stays walking forward. So what she's done is you can see that she's taking herself tall and more together. She's sitting very relaxed but tall, and what she's asked the horse to do is basically follow her into that same setup. So push him out onto a longer rein again, George. Good. So you can see that George is still sitting tall but more relaxed. Her hips are free. You can see her hips working along with the horse, just swinging along with the horse. Yeah, and when we talk about pushing a horse, we don't want to drive with the seat. The seat has an influence. So here we're wanting the horse to be more free, so we come a little bit more free through our hips. And you'll see in a moment when I ask her to pick up the rein, what she would do is she would restrict the degree of flexion through her hips, which then helps shorten the stride. What you don't want to do is you don't want to lean back and drive from your seat. You drive anything too hard, it eventually stops going. You keep pushing something, by nature, they stop going. We want the horse to want to take us, and then our position, you know, how we utilize our hips can influence the size of the stride, whether we want them to come a little bit more open or a little bit shorter, but it shouldn't keep the horse going.